A quarter century of service. 25 years of helping people survive. And today, the Trauma One program at Shands Jacksonville continues to provide unparalleled service to the communities in and around Northeast Florida.
What it means to you is that you have a dedicated team of people that are trained and experts in trauma. And they're here 24 hours a day, 365 days a year.
We all know our role, so we know exactly what we need to do the minute the patient arrives. And we all kind of gather around, we assess the patient from head to toe, and then decide what is needed from there.
Teamwork, fighting together to bring those on the brink of death back to life. Those qualities were needed as much as ever on a life-changing night in June 2009.
The odds were markedly against her even surviving, let alone having a good recovery.
The life that Ashley knew, the one her family knew, changed forever on Father's Day in June 2009. When that day began, the Baker County woman looked like this, all smiles. But when the day ended, a different picture, as Ashley began a fight for her life, a roller coaster struggle that brought her to the brink of death.
We received a call from the local police department that Ashley and her friend had been in an accident, and they were coming to our home to pick us up.
Ashley was riding on the back of an ATV with a friend when he lost control. The freak accident sent both of them flying off the four-wheeler. Ashley's body slammed into a tree. She was severely injured and rushed to Shands. Her family was close behind.
I kind of lost it for a minute. I couldn't speak because he didn't tell me things were good.
My inner mother knew my baby's hurt bad. I mean, I knew it. I felt it. I think I asked them if she was alive. I think I asked that. I don't recall an answer of yes or no.
When Ashley came into the trauma center, she was in a life-threatening situation. She was already in shock.
So emergency responders began doing what they consider normal, but what we see as amazing. From the moment the accident took place, the fight began to save Ashley. Doctors say CPR performed at the scene was the first step, and then an ambulance rushed her to meet Trauma One, which couldn't land in the thick forest. Doctors say the actions taken by the Trauma One crew on board the helicopter were crucial to keeping Ashley alive.
Well, just a lot of prayers. You never want to lose a child, so you're willing to take them however you can get them. But we hope for the best, and put our faith in God, and He took care of her.
Ashley was rushed into surgery several times. For days, doctors didn't know if she'd make it. There were setbacks. She went into cardiac arrest several times, but was revived. Her lungs gave out, and while caregivers waited, anxiously waited, a special machine was brought in from Orlando. Throughout, her family was at her side, waiting, praying.
For me, one of the most difficult moments at Shands was the first full day following the accident, which I think was Monday. When you hear that the physicians and the staff have used all of their resources and they've said, if she can just hold on. I think that was definitely the hardest time.
It was the hardest thing I'd ever went through in my life. I mean, it's just devastating. You know, when you hear your little sister, you know, she might not make it.
And it got to the point where we kind of pull out our extreme measures. Our conventional modes of ventilation and support weren't working.
We stayed together during those times, and they were hard, you know, we knew we had each other to lean on.
Doctors aren't sure why it happened or how Ashley pulled through, but she did, slowly but surely. 4 weeks after the accident, 4 long weeks of uncertainty, And the family's patience and the dedicated work of the staff at UF and Shands were rewarded when Ashley was well enough to leave the hospital for rehabilitation.
The recovery from injuries of this magnitude is a marathon, it's not a sprint. And so the first leg is just surviving. And then from there, you kind of see how you finish the race. And that takes a lot of recovery time. And we're fortunate that Ashley was able to go to Brooks, which is an exceptional rehab facility.
But just knowing Ashley made it this far was relief for her family.
When we left her, she still was unable, you know, to speak or move or communicate with us, you know, other than possibly a little with her eyes. But I knew that if they were going to release her, at least I felt like that they thought she was at least going to survive.
Their praise for all her caregivers never ends.
They are very special individuals to dedicate their life to seeing such tragedy day after day and dealing with it.
It's amazing to me because I know that looking at it and looking at the extent of the injuries, if I was to hear about this with somebody else, it's just amazing that somebody would, you know, survive from that, you know, and have a normal life.
I think of it every day when I look at her, you know, it's, you know, we still have her, and we cherish every moment together.
3, 2, 1.
Nearly a year after the accident, after months of recovery at Brooks Rehabilitation and at home, Ashley was back at Shands to cut the ribbon for a new trauma intensive care unit. The people who took care of her, who brought her back to life, were amazed at what they saw.
Oh my God. Oh my. She's busy.
I can tell you, I will always remember Ashley Davis. When I have a really, really bad day and somebody's not doing well and I think maybe it's time that there's not much else I can do, I remember her.
It's thrilling when you can see a patient who was so horribly injured and then they've come through it and they're much better.
It's one of the ones that will always stick in my mind and keep me, you know, keep me going. It keeps me going on bad days.
Were they sweet?
Ashley and those who love her say they will never forget the people at Shands and the emergency responders who saved her life. And they have a message for you.
The doctors and the staff, they cannot be commended enough for their efforts and their talents. And thank God has given them wonderful talents to do their work. And they're a special group of people.
They didn't give up on someone's life that wasn't even really connected to them. It wasn't their child, it wasn't their sister or loved one, but they valued her life.
I'm overjoyed because she's here to be honored. I'm very thankful for the people that cared for her and feel like she has come to the point in life when they can honor her. I'm just overwhelmed, I really am.
All I can say is thank you for not giving up on me when things seemed hopeless and the chances of any survival it wasn't very likely, but yet y'all were still persistent to try and to keep pushing. And
grapes are all squishy.
Like one of the nurses told me, we weren't gonna give up and let you go that easy. And that really stood out to me because, like I said, when chances were so slim, it was, no, you know, we've got to keep trying, got to keep trying. And because you did, I'm here.